I'll go ahead and there's lots of data here. Do I have a clicker or somebody else? Next slide, please. Or can I have a mouse or a clicker here? We formed Tugon Kabuhayan with Atty. Aziz Perez. He had much earlier formed and led Kanggol Kalikasan. In his youth, they physically ran after illegal lads and lads from the river. Then they moved on, sustaining that they formed Kanggol Kalikasan, where not only could they protect against destruction, they planted and planted. And one of the times we were chatting and reviewing our life, we discussed that it's probably more sustainable if we address the livelihood. Kung wala na yung project, funding, support, mahirap i-sustain ang natalima natin. But if the people in the community benefits from a healthy environment, then it will stay. Aquaculture, we're in aquaculture. Let me just make it clear, we are not fish hunters. We don't capture and harvest fish. We farm fish. And it is to our selfish interest to help maintain a healthy environment. For without clean water, all our investment and hard work are gone. Funding numbers. The numbers are based on FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization. And let me qualify already, according to FAO, some countries overstate, some countries understate. China is known to be overstating, because the bureaucrat who shows good numbers are rewarded. They get tax credit. Business get tax credit. Sa atin, we get tax money visiting. They get promoted, we get trouble. They get instantly more budget the next year, we get instantly more quota the next year. So we tend to understate, they tend to overstate. But 178 million metric tons, 178 billion kilos for 7 billion people. That's more production for 2020. 1950s, it was 99% sea cash. Doon pa lang muna umpisa ang aquaculture. So aquaculture, fish farming is a very young industry. So young, we don't even know how to categorize our data. We don't even have an orderly data structure. But look at how we have grown. 1950 to current, we have overtaken sea cash. Sea cash with all their newer vessel, bigger vessel, bigger, better vessel with their helicopters and their drone and their sonar boys, all the new tech, only allows them to catch what they were catching in the past. And there is no hope for it to increase. But in our culture, we're growing and we can grow more as the public and your industry learn about us. More data. What we have submitted is what we have all these things. I'll skip some. These are photos of sea cages. We locally make this now, high density polyethylene. In Europe, these are used up to 25 meter diameter in the treacherous sea. Over here, we use it up to 18 meter diameter, 1-2 kilometers offshore. Big number, 170 billion kilos, value of $281 billion, approximately 90 pesos a kilo, worldwide average farming price, similar to our tilapia farming price. Philippine data based on ESA, Philippine Statistics Authority, which I believe had understated our production by very much. But nonetheless, PSA data, and later on there will be a data from the Food and Nutrition Institute of the Department of Science and Technology. We have 4.3 billion kilos a year. Not bad, right? Worldwide is 178. Domestic, we produce 4.3. Understated. Even our tuna import, a big part of our tuna import are actually catch of Filipino-owned vessel, Filipino-manned vessel, catching them in the high seas and in other countries that they have to retract to be able to have the permits. We keep subdividing our data. So we subdivide data, aquaculture, marine, commercial, inland municipal. Obviously, this doesn't even show Batanes. Batanes would have their Dorado. Breakfast, we have Langit. It doesn't show. PSA data for Region 11, give you as an example. PSA data for the whole of Region 11 is a lot less than my friend Jotong's farm at Malalang Bay in Davao Occidental, or Davao or Occidental. More subdivision of our data. I don't know what they do by non-food purposes. But if you, for your interest, look at the frozen number. Frozen is increasing rapidly. Frozen food, frozen seafood, domestic production at 35% of all our production. It's more important to freeze seafood than chicken or hams because of bacterial growth. No country started freezing killer species, but believe me, right? Everybody started, all civilizations started with sea catch, then progressed. The more developed country, Europe and US, are primarily frozen seafood. In Asia and in our country, it's more of fresh, chilled, dried, fermented, and go home. But expect us to follow the growth of civilization, that we will have more and more frozen seafood. Fresh, domestic, frozen. Domestic, fresh, frozen. To ensure the freshness. You have chicken, you have hogs, hogs maybe Robata, Sakura, you have beef, Angus, Kobe, but look at seafood. We have so many species. Essentially, I don't know how they sorted the list. It's not alphabetical, it's not by language, but that's from a before document. This data is from the Food and Nutrition Institute.